स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक अरिथमेटिक इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ 8085 माइक्रोप्रोसेसर। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस यू हैव सीन इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ ग्रुप 1 एंड ग्रुप 2। नाउ यू विल स्टडी रेस्ट ऑफ द इंस्ट्रक्शंस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक। द फर्स्ट वन इज इंक्रीमेंट इंस्ट्रक्शंस। इन दीस टाइप ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस द कंटेंट्स ऑफ द ऑपरेंड विल बी इंक्रीमेंटेड बाय 1। नाउ द फर्स्ट वन इज INR, एंड ऑपरेंड कैन बी एनी जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर or the memory location. Let us understand by the example INR B. For this I am assuming that register B is holding an 8-bit number FF hex before the instruction. And when I am writing INR B, it means that source operand, which is the register B, contents will be incremented by 1 and saved in the same place, that is the register B. So after the instruction, register B will have 00 hex. What about the flags? All flags will be affected except the carry flag. So carry flag will not change. Now moving ahead, the next instruction is INX, and operand is any register pair or the stack pointer. Here X is signifying that the size of the operand will be 16 bit. For example, INX B. So this instruction will increment the contents of the register pair or the stack pointer by 1. It will not affect any flags of the 8085 microprocessor. So there will be no effect on flags. Now let's see another instruction. Decrement instructions. These instructions are used to decrement the contents of the operand by 1. As we have seen in the INR instruction, the DCR instruction, where the operand can be in a general purpose register or the memory location, will decrement the contents of the operand by 1. Example is DCR D. Let us assume that register D has 00 hex number. So after writing the instruction DCR D, which means that the source operand contents will be decremented by 1 and result will be saved in the same place, that is register D. For this subtraction, you have to find out the 2's complement of the 1, which is, so its 2's complement is FF hex. So after finding the 2's complement of 1, add that value into the contents of the register D. So after the instruction, register D will hold FF hex value. Once again, ignore the effect on carry, or you can say that DCR will not affect the carry flag, rest of the flags will be modified. Now the next instruction is DCX. In DCX instruction, here X is used to signify that the size of the operand is 16 bit, and these operands can be any general purpose register pair or stack pointer. So register pairs in the 8085 microprocessor are B, D and H. So it will decrement the contents of the operand by 1. So in the example DCXD, it will decrease the contents of the this register pair, which has register D and E. Register D will be upper byte register and register E will be the lower byte register of this register pair. So this will decrease its content by 1, and once again DCX will not modify, or there is no effect of this instruction on any flags. Now the next instruction is DAA instruction. This instruction is used after the addition operation. So let's understand this opcode first. This opcode stands for decimal adjust accumulator. So this instruction is used to change the contents of the accumulator from binary value to BCD digits. How this operation is performed? After the addition, it will look into the contents of the accumulator. First, the lower 4-bit value. If that 4-bit value is greater than 9 or auxiliary carry is 1, then DAA instruction adds 6 to this lower 4 bit values, and same for the upper 4 bits values. If carry flag value is 1, or the upper 4 bit values of D7 to D4 is greater than 9, then DAA instruction adds 6 to this upper 4 bit values. And if both are greater than 9, lower 4 bit and upper 4 bit, then it will add 66 in the total 8 bit value of the accumulator. So let's understand this instruction with an example. Let us suppose the contents of the accumulator is 39 BCD and we want to add 42 BCD value into this content of accumulator. Let's first add these two numbers and find out the total BCD value. So it is 39 plus 42, this will be 81. So this is in terms of BCD, but in microprocessor it will first convert this number into binary equivalent, so it will be 001 and 1001. So this is 39 and then 42 is 0100 and 2 is 0010. Adding these two numbers, 1 plus 0 1, again 1, 0 1, 1 1 1 and 0. This number is equals to 7B hex. So we want to convert the binary value into the 4-bit BCD digits. For that, just look into this 8-bit value. It is 7B. So lower 4-bit is greater than the 9. So I will add 06 into this number. So this will be, once again, the binary conversion 0111 and B is 1011. And 6, adding 6 into this number, so 0110, this will be 10, carry over 100, once again carry over 1, so 0001, which is equals to 81. Now you can see that DA instruction is finally converted this binary value into the BCD value. Now moving ahead, next instruction is DAD instruction. This instruction is used to directly add two 16-bit numbers. Let's first understand this opcode DAD. DAD is the short form of direct add or direct addition. So this instruction will directly add the contents of HL register pair with the operon contents, and operon can be any general purpose register pair or the stack pointer value. Let us understand by this example that D. For this, I am assuming that register pair D is holding an 16-bit number 41FF hex and register pair H, which is the destination operon for this instruction. So register pair H is holding a number 2001 hex. So after using this instruction DAD D, it will add the contents of source operon, that is the register pair D, into the destination operon, that is register pair H, and save the 16-bit result into register pair H, which is the default destination operon. So adding these two numbers, we will have, after the instruction, HL will have 6200 hex, and what about the DE register pair? There will be no effect of that instruction into the source operon contents, so it will remain same, while the register pair H, which is the destination operon, will get modified. If there is a carry in the addition process, then only carry flag will be affected. Otherwise, there will be no change in the flags. Now, let's revise some important points from the topic. The first one is, in instruction INR and DCR, all flags are affected except the carry flag. INX and DCX instructions will not affect any flags. And next, in the DAD instruction, the default destination operand is register pair H. And if the result is greater than 16 bits, then only carry flag is set, otherwise no flags will be affected. And the last one is, in DAA instruction, it is used to convert the result of an addition from binary value to BCD digits. And in this operation, all the flags are affected. Now, these are the frequently asked questions from the topic. Specify the register contents and flag status as the following instructions are executed. Don't forget to complement the carry flag after the subtraction. Next is, write an ALP to find square of an 8-bit number. This can be done in very simple way using DAD instruction. Students, I hope you like the video. So please subscribe to the channel for more contents. And if you have any queries regarding microprocessor 8085, 8086, 8051 microcontroller or in analog electronics or digital electronics, VLSI, semiconductor physics, you can contact me. My mail ID is given in the description of the video. Thank you so much.